As long as you take up his identity, as long as your name is identified as Christ, everything that he has belongs to you. That means that if God says there's nothing that can harm his son, because that is his identity in his father, that means there's nothing that can harm you. That's why the Bible says, surely they will gather together. He says, surely. Listen, just because you're going through something should not discourage you. Listen, whatever you're going through should not discourage you. Because God says that surely you will go through it. It is bad for you to go through it. But he says, surely they shall gather together. But their gathering shall be what? In vain. God said they will not prosper. And the Bible says, for they will come in one way. And I will disperse them, what? In seven ways. And listen, and he says, no weapon. No weapon that fashion against you. And listen, and God said no weapon, regardless of what that weapon is. It might be a weapon of words. Yes. What people have said against you. Yes. The Bible says no weapon. Yes. It might be God. Yes. The Bible said no weapon. I don't care what it, but the Bible said no weapon that fashion against you. He said, and the word fashion means, regardless of the way they put it together, regardless of their imagination, regardless of their purpose, the weapon that fashion against you, what would happen? They will not prosper. It's because what? You gain access. Gaining access. If you go to the book of Philippians chapter 2, Philippians chapter 2, reading from verse 6. It says, Philippians 2, verse 6 says, who being in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God. Verse 7 says, but made himself of no reputation and took upon him the form of a servant. A form of a servant. Underline that word. I want to underline, took upon him the form of a servant and was made in the likeness of men. Jesus Christ had to take a form of a servant and made in the likeness of men. And what does it mean by making the likeness of men? He was subjected to death. The Bible says the wages of sin is death. Jesus Christ took the form of a servant and he took the sin of this world and laid upon himself. And he took the sin of the past, he took the sin of the present, and he took the sin of the future, and he laid it upon himself, and he went to the cross. And he went to the cross just once. Jesus Christ is not going back to the cross for nobody else. He only does it once. You only have the opportunity to say yes once. And if after yes once you didn't say yes, Jesus Christ is moving up to somebody else. That's why it is very important to say yes. Without saying yes, you cannot gain access to him. Without saying yes, you're still going to be a servant. Without saying yes, you are the mercy of Satan. Whatever Satan gives to you, that's what you're going to take. Without saying yes, you do not have the right to go into the house. Without saying yes, you need permission. And not only just saying yes, you have to be transformed to his image. Your life has to match up. Listen, you cannot say that this is your father and you still live out of the will of your father. You can't say this is my father. Your life have to live in that form. May the Lord help us in Jesus' name. Amen. That is why it is important to gain access. Gaining access makes you not to pray unnecessary prayer. I've been working on a message for a long time. Some blessings that you don't have to pray for. Some blessings. Listen, if my dad is the president of the United States, there are some doors I will walk into just because of him. It does not, listen, right now, before I can go into any business, like if I, you know, I can, let's take example, Microsoft, I like computer. Before I can walk into Microsoft, they will look at my credential. How much degree you have? How much have you been the technician or what? You know, how long have you been doing this? But if my father is the president of the United States, I will walk in and everybody will say, yes, sir. It's because I'm a son. I might not have the degree. They will be begging me to take the job. Wow. Without any degree, they will be begging me, oh, this president's son, just take the job. Because I'm working in the identity of my father. The day I said to myself, if my father is the president, and I said to myself, I don't want to work in the identity of my father, guess what? I become a common man. I will have to work hard as a regular person to gain access. There are some rights you have in God that you don't have to work hard for. Because you are a son and not a servant. Being born again is the only way to qualify as a son. If you go with me to the book of Romans.